suddenly the tragedy of it all would kind of hit you and you would be tremendously sad. And
it's a love letter to this community that we love. And
we did start on the same television show.
Growing Pains.
89-90.
Quentin Tarantino is at it again with his ninth film that is set to rock the socks off of summer 2019. The all-star cast of Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, which is said to be separated into thematic chapters a la Pulp Fiction, includes Leonardo DiCaprio, Brad Pitt, and Margot Robbie, among other well-known Hollywood actors. Seriously, this cast is so huge that they even had to cut out some of their actors. We're taking an inside look at the real-life stars that were portrayed in this film and what it took to bring Hollywood in 1969 back to life. After 8 feature-length directing credits and more than 20 years atop the Hollywood hierarchy, director Quentin Tarantino has earned a reputation that makes any project he's working on a big deal. His next film, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, due July 26, 2019, has no shortage of star power. While the storyline of this film is based on real people and real events, its overall plot is not a true story. Quentin Tarantino has been working on the script for half a decade and aims to show a side of LA and Hollywood that a lot of people have seemingly forgotten. Though the movie is largely fictional, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood intertwines real people into the story and uses Charles Manson, his followers, and their terrible deeds as a backdrop. But Tarantino's inspiration for the film came from what some refer to as the golden age of Hollywood and its revolutionary shift. Leonardo DiCaprio stars in the film as a character named Rick Dalton. Now, Rick Dalton is a fictional character, but his story is very real to so many actors during the late 1960s in Hollywood. Almost every other character in this film is based on a real person, though, but we'll get to that in a minute. Leo's character, Rick Dalton, is at the height of his television career as a Western actor, but Steve McQueen's a real person, but played by Damian Lewis, his career was in the same place. The magazines are constantly pitting these two against each other in a who's the biggest hunk type of way, Tarantino says. Rick and Steve are essentially neck and neck with two successful and extremely similar TV shows going for them. In this story, Steve McQueen jumps to film, essentially leaving Rick Dalton in the dust. When Rick tries to pull off the TV to film transition, it doesn't go as well and there's a lot of "I'm a has-been" kind of dialogue. So essentially, Tarantino was inspired by the wake of the new Hollywood that was coming in 1969.
At some point in my life, about Hollywood. Behind the scenes.
A different Hollywood. It's the late 60s and counterculture is in full swing with hippies everywhere and lots of rock and roll. The golden age of Hollywood has peaked and is starting to fade as the industry shifts. He focuses also on a tight friendship between Leo's character Rick and the other huge star of this film, Brad Pitt. Brad plays Rick's stunt double Cliff Booth. Cliff Booth is also fictional, but like we said, pretty much everyone else is not. These two fictional characters and best friends are struggling to make their way in a Hollywood that they don't know anymore. But things shift when Rick realizes he has a famous neighbor, Sharon Tate, played by Margot Robbie. Leo and Brad Pitt's characters are fictional, as we've said, though their friendship bears a strong resemblance to that of Hollywood legend Burt Reynolds and his stuntman Hal Needham. So who were the real-life people portrayed in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood? As we said, Margot Robbie plays Sharon Tate. In 1969, Sharon Tate's career was taking off. She was formerly a model and had just begun to make her way into the silver screen around 1967. She worked on a horror comedy film, The Fearless Vampire Killers, directed by Roman Polanski, who she married in 1968. Roman Polanski is played by Rafael Zawiruka in the film. During the setting of the film, 1969, Sharon Tate is 8.5 months pregnant with her and Polanski's child. Dakota Fanning is also in the film, playing Lynette Fromm, aka Squeaky Fromm, a diehard member of the Manson family and claims she still loves Charles Manson to this day. Though never directly connected to any Manson family terrible deeds, Squeaky did protest in and out of the courthouse throughout the trial. She also attempted to follow through on some attempts against President Gerald Ford in 1975 and spent 34 years behind bars. The notorious Charles Manson, famous for heinous deeds and leading the cult called the Manson family, is just a truly evil human being. Though Manson, a notoriously terrible person and failed musician, was convicted due to his major role. This intense character is played by Aussie actor Damon Harriman, who you may recognize from Justified. Like we mentioned, Damien Hirst will play the famous Steve McQueen. McQueen was a movie star who became known for his iconic action scenes and car chases in particular, and was one of the biggest stars in the world during the 1960s with roles in films such as The Great Escape. He was a personal friend of Sharon Tate and Roman Polanski's and was planning to attend a dinner party at the couple's home that is portrayed in the film where the heinous Manson crime took place. McQueen skipped the party as he'd met a woman beforehand and spent the evening with her instead. Rumor Willis also appears in this film, playing a famous friend of Sharon Tate's. The British actress Joanna Pettit and another friend, Barbara Lewis, came over for lunch at 10050 Cielo Drive earlier on the day Sharon Tate's life was ended. That night was the infamous dinner party that would be each guest's last meal. Emil Hirsch plays Jay Sebring. He was a celebrity hairstylist who dated Sharon Tate before the actress met Polanski. Jay Sebring later befriended the director and remained friends with Sharon. He was with Tate and fellow guests that fateful night at Cielo Drive. As some of the Manson family, we have a few recognizable names too. Austin Butler plays Charles Tex Watson, a central member of Manson's family who committed multiple crimes and was later convicted. Popular 1960s actress and singer Connie Stevens will be played by Don't Trust the Bee in Apartment 23 alum Jerima Walker. And even Lena Dunham is in this film. She portrays Catherine Gypsy Cher, a follower of Manson who did not participate in the crimes committed on Cielo Drive. Now this is an impressive cast list, with even more well-known names in some roles. Heck, Pacino and Kurt Russell are in it. But the rest of the cast, as big as it is, made room for other stars such as Timothy Olyphant, Mike Moe, and the late Luke Perry, who said doing this film was on his bucket list. But a surprising fact about this film is that there were actually more actors in it. In fact, it was practically bursting at the seams with stars. The film, which clocks in at a whopping 159 minutes, was actually longer before this cut, and unfortunately that means some scenes and some actors needed to be cut out. James Marsden of Westworld, X-Men, and Hairspray was one such casualty, being cut from the film entirely. Danny Strong of Empire, James Remar of Dexter, and even a frequent collaborator of Tarantino's, Tim Roth, all were cut from the film. Even some of the big stars in this film don't get the screen time many of us would like to see. Margot Robbie is one of the bigger names in this cast and doesn't get nearly the screen time that Brad Pitt and Leonardo DiCaprio do. IndieWire describes the Pitt and DiCaprio character story as a bromance that encompasses the whole film. Maybe that's why so many actors had to be cut from the film. The pure star power that the two leads bring to the screen was too much, and the film simply had to have enough room for them to shine? Maybe. For some of these stars, bringing the film to life was simply counting on one another and their love of film. The movie has been described as a love letter to LA, and Leonardo DiCaprio said the film was Tarantino's homage to cinema, to the unrecognized people on the sidelines.
Absolute love story to Los Angeles and this time period.
These two actors were able to click with the overall themes of this film by simply remembering the Hollywood that once was, and as Brad Pitt says, remembering a part of our childhood. Brad Pitt and Leo said they really leaned on one another, as this was their first film together. The two characters' relationship is a special one. Not only are they great friends, but the Hollywood of the 50s and 60s was different. Back then, actors would team up with one stuntman for a whole series of films and TV shows. So these two huge stars, Leo and Brad, had to show that kind of special brotherhood that the golden era of Hollywood once birthed. Tarantino explained that his choice to have Brad Pitt in the film is because, I thought he would be terrific in this character because it needs a terrific actor. But it also needs a movie star, and particularly a movie star like Mr. Pitt, a movie star that I think audiences like watching. You like watching the way he moves, you like watching the way he drives, this cool, masculine quality that a movie star can have, he has it. And he's had it for this whole last generation of actors. Not too shabby a review from one of the most prolific filmmakers of the last 20 years. For a film about two stars in Hollywood, these two actual stars seemed to work really well together. DiCaprio said there was incredible ease and comfort getting to work alongside Brad, and added, "It was incredibly easy working with Brad, and I think we forged a great cinematic bond in a film about our industry together." Brad Pitt said, "You don't have to carry the whole thing. You've got these other great people who are the best of the best and are going to help carry that load. It's actually a relief," describing working with Leo. This all feels incredibly in tune with their actual characters in the film, which makes us all think that this was perfectly cast. In an interview on the Today Show, Margot Robbie opened up about playing the late Sharon. Margot said, "I was never really exposed to the parts of her life when she was alive," and added, "It would kind of hit you at moments. Suddenly, the tragedy of it all would kind of hit you and you would be tremendously sad." For her preparation for the film, she actually got to meet with Sharon Tate's sister, Deborah Tate, who gave Margot her blessing and even lent her some of Sharon's jewelry for the film. It's hard not to look at those shots of Brad and Leo and Quentin and Margot at the red carpet at the Cannes Film Festival and get the sense this film is something big, something iconic. It was reported that the film got a 7-minute standing ovation, for goodness sake. It's a biopic that has a nod to a Hollywood that once was, with real stories about real stars and a cast of real stars too. All in all, the story in this film is turning heads in summer of 2019. Brad Pitt told GQ, "They don't make movies like this anymore, so we have a feeling this one is going to stick with us all for a long time."
Would you do it again?
Would you?
Of course.
What do you think of the stories being portrayed in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood? Are you excited to see the film, or are you feeling skeptical about such sensitive stories? Let us know what you think in the comments section. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time here at The Taco.